I'm swinging that hammer, babe. I'm swinging that hammer, babe. Yes, I'm swinging that hammer, babe.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
And today I'm going to tell you about my Guild Nightbird ST. This is not a review because this guitar is not stock. And number two, it's so rare that you're not likely to ever find one of these. So there's no sense in rushing over to a musician's friend or American Musical Supply. You will not find this guitar. I bought it in 1997 at Seminole Music. Walked in and was looking for a Les Paul style guitar, and Jeff, who's the manager and who's still the manager today, told me about this Guild sitting over in the corner. It's really beat up and messed up, so he only wanted $300 for it, and I took it. It turns out it was the best purchase of a guitar I've ever made in my life. This thing was made in 1990, and it's number 7 of only 20 on the planet. So it's super, super, super rare. Let me show you a few things that are special about the guitar first. First and foremost is, you see how flat, how thin it is? It's just kind of like a Strat. And another thing that's kind of Strat-like about it is the way that they carve this part of the body away, so it sits right there on your rib cage, nice and comfortably, instead of digging in like a Les Paul does. I really like that. Another feature that's really cool, wraparound tail pieces have been around for years, but this was the first time I had seen a guitar with this style where it had adjustable adjustments in the saddles, and just the whole design of it was something I'd never seen before. I thought that was a pretty unique thing. Also, I like the two knob setup, the volume and tone. I don't like four knobs. It's too much stuff to mess with, and to be honest with you, I don't do any of that blending stuff that people do with other knobs. I run my guitar wide open the whole time. Some modifications that I made to it are the pickups. The original pickups were Kent Armstrong's, I'm fairly certain. They were really thrashed, had almost no output. Just didn't like how they sounded. They were pretty much done. They didn't have any life left in them. So I swapped them out for, in the neck, that is a Seymour Duncan Fat Cat. Humbucker size P90. And in the bridge is also Seymour Duncan, that's the Pearly Gates. This is like, your old Gibson pickups that you find on a Les Paul, but with a little more output, a little more sizzle to it. Same thing with the P90 up here. It's a little hotter, a little more output than your typical P90 pickup. And that's what I prefer on a guitar. This is my preferred pickup combination. I like old style Gibson pickups that have a little bit more output to them. And I really like the way a P90 sounds in the neck. Something else about the guitar. When I first got it, the neck was beat up really bad. This was all chipped up. And whenever I would play first couple of years, it was like running my hands over gravel every time I played the guitar, and it just got annoying. So I took a razor blade and took all the loose paint off and some sandpaper, sanded everything down, made it smooth, and put tongue oil on it. And now it's the fastest, most comfortable neck I've ever felt on a guitar. I love it. So that's it. That's my Guild Nightbird ST. I'm going to put some songs in the video so you can hear what it sounds like cranked up, rocking out. And I also put a song on there so you can hear what it sounds like clean. Just to give you an idea of what this pickup combination sounds like on a guitar like this. And,
yeah, Jethro Tull, this love machine.